Welcome to Alanis Business Academy. I'm Matt Alanis, and this is How to Measure Gross Domestic Product. Gross Domestic Product, often referred to simply by the acronym GDP, represents the total market value of finished goods and services produced within a nation's borders over a specified period of time. Unlike Gross National Product, GDP includes even finished goods and services produced by foreign companies as long as those goods and services are produced within the country whose GDP is being measured. Calculated primarily on a quarterly and annual basis, GDP is commonly used to gauge the health of an economy. To really make sense of GDP, we need to know what it includes. The basic formula for determining a nation's gross domestic product is C plus G plus I plus NX. Each of these variables represents a different source of spending. The C represents consumer spending, also known as personal consumption, which is the amount of money spent by consumers on finished goods and services. Consumer spending in the United States accounts for the largest percentage of GDP, totaling approximately 65 to 70% altogether. G represents spending by all levels of government. At the time of this video, U.S. government spending as a whole has been decreasing as a percentage of GDP. This is partly due to the sequester at the federal level, as well as lower property tax revenues at the local level. Although revenue from property taxes is improving, it is nowhere near its original level at the height of the housing market. The next contributing factor towards gross domestic product is I, which represents business spending on goods and services. These expenditures commonly take the form of raw materials, vehicles, factories, machinery, computers, as well as office fixtures and furniture. Although it only represents approximately 15% of GDP, U.S. business investment is still important due to its contribution towards productivity as well as job creation. The last contributing factor is NX, which represents the nation's total net exports. This can be calculated by taking the amount of a country's exports, meaning goods produced domestically and sold in another country, and subtracting what the country imports or what is brought in after being produced in another country. Although U.S. total net exports are historically negative and thus do not contribute positively to GDP, recent increases in U.S. oil production have lessened dependency on foreign oil and produced positive net exports for the second quarter of 2013. As an economic indicator, GDP is one of the most widely cited and useful gauges of the health of a nation's economy. By measuring GDP over time, it makes it possible to compare GDP from quarter to quarter, as well as year to year, in an attempt to determine whether the economy is growing. Like all measures, though, GDP has its shortcomings. For example, a common criticism of GDP is that it fails to measure the underground economy, which is impossible to determine due to how these transactions occur. Despite this, GDP remains a reliable indicator to measure the health of a nation's economy. This has been How to Measure Gross Domestic Product. For questions, please leave them in the comment box below, and I'll do my best to get back to those in a timely fashion. If you're interested in learning more about economics, check out the playlist titled Economics, and also subscribe to Alanis Business Academy for videos on other business topics. Lastly, do remember to like and share this video with your friends. Thanks for watching.